This is my video number 64. I have given problems from 15 to 26. That is 12 problems. And it is continued of video number 63. Here, look at the take the screenshot of the problems. Do by yourself. After that, you should check whether you are correct or not. All these problems you should observe that there is a quadratic function whose root over is there, and in number 24 it is a special problem which is very very important for your exam point of view. Now look at number 50. Dx by 4x square minus 4x plus 5. Look at there, number 15. A 4x square minus 4x. Make it a complete square, that is 2x whole square, that is 2x whole square is 4x square minus 2 into 2x plus 1 square. Then it becomes 4x square minus 4x plus 1, then write this 4 here. Now it is 2x minus 1 whole square, from this to this it is 2x minus 1 whole square plus 2 square, dx by 2x minus 1 square plus 2 square. And write this as dx means derivative of 2x minus 1. Derivative of 2x minus 1 is 2dx minus 0. 2dx, so you have to multiply half into 2dx. And half d of 2x minus 1 divided by 2x minus 1 square plus 2 square, 1 by 2. It is d box by box square plus a square. The formula is what? Ln box plus box square plus a square root over. Remember the formula. D box by box square plus a square. I have given in chapter 4. I have given the formula. And apply here. Now look at there. Just simple. 16, 15, 16. They are very similar. It is 2x minus 4x square minus 4x plus 4. This 2x minus 1 whole square plus 2 square. First you have to convert this quadratic to a complete square. 2x minus 1 whole square plus 2 square. Put t is equal to 2x minus 1. dt is equal to 2 dx. So in place of dx you have to write half dt. And it is t square plus 2 square. And the result is 1 by 2. It is t by 2. T square plus 2 square root over plus a square by 2. 2 square by 2. Ln t plus t square plus a square root over. I have given this formula in chapter 6, in chapter 5, that is in integration of partial fraction. In that chapter I have told you box square plus a square root over, that is box by 2, box square plus a square by 2, ln box square plus a square root over. And putting the value of 2, you will get the answer. Now, number 17, this is x minus 3 whole square minus 4. You will apply the formula and do by yourself. 6, 17, 18. And this is 19, I am doing, it is 1 plus 2x minus x square. I will do only 1 of 19 and 20. Okay, I am doing 20. You should do rest problems. Look at number 20, 1 plus 2x minus x square whole root over, it is 1, you have to adjust this minus x square. Here, look at here, take minus here, it becomes x square, then take minus 2x. Why you will take minus 2x? So that it becomes minus x square plus 2x. So, you put your 1 here. After that, what you will do? To convert this a complete square, it is 1 is required here. So it becomes x square minus 2x plus 1. But finally it is minus 1. What you have to do here? You have to put 2 here. Because 2 minus 1 is 1. So it becomes 2 minus x minus 1 whole square. And in place of this dx, you can write d of x minus 1. Now what formula is applied here? A square minus box square root over. Formula is what? A square minus box square root over dx integration is box by 2 a square minus box square plus x by 2 means box by 2
sin inverse box by a.
Okay, plus c. Box by 2, it is box by 2, it is a square by 2, sorry. Box by 2 means what? Box means here t, t by 2, a square minus x square, जो यहाँ था वही रहेगा, 2 minus t square root of plus a square by 2, a square means root 2 rho square, that is 2 by 2, sin inverse t box by a, box means t by root 2, then putting the value of t, you will get the answer. Look at problem number 21 and 22, they are very important for exam point of view. And in these two problems, one linear is there and there is one quadratic. There is a rule. What is that rule? If in an integration one is a linear one, another is a root over of quadratic, you have to put linear is equal to 1 by 3. Otherwise, you cannot do the problem. You have to put linear is equal to 1 by t. Here it is linear, here it is quadratic. Linear is equal to 1 by t. Linear means 1 plus x is equal to 1 by t. What is dx? It is a derivative 1 by t, L minus 1 by t square dt. Don't write L and t. It is integration of 1 by t dt is L and t. Derivative. Remember, the students are doing wrong in this point. So, dx is equal to minus 1 by t square dt. I am putting one box there. Because I will put the value of dx. Next, tell me, what is x? X is a 1 by t minus 1. I want 1 minus x square. So, 1 minus x square, 1 minus x means what? 1 by t minus 1 whole square. Then expand it by applying a minus b whole square. It becomes 1 minus x square is minus 1 by t square plus 2 by t. Take LCM, it becomes 2t minus 1 by t square. So, 1 minus x square root over is 2t minus 1 root over by t. Putting, I am making one box here. And look at here, dx, I am writing in place of dx minus 1 by t square dt, and 1 plus x I am writing 1 by t, in place of 1 minus x square root over I am writing 2t minus 1 by 2t minus 1 root over by t, t t t square, they cancel, minus dt by 2t minus 1. Now here as it is root over 2t minus 1, so put t z square is equal to 2t minus 1, 2z dz is equal to 2 dt. So, it becomes in place of dt, I am writing z dz, I am writing 2t minus 1 root over z, cancel this, it becomes minus z plus c, in place of z put 2t minus 1 root over plus c, minus 2t minus 1 root over, in place of t, t is what? 1 plus x 1 by t, so take t here, t is equal to 1 by 1 plus x, so apply 1 by 1 plus x, it is 2, by 1 plus x minus 1 root over plus c, simplify, it becomes minus 1 minus x by 1 plus x, so whole root over, okay. Now look at number 22, it is dx by 2 minus x, 5 minus 4x plus x square, it is dx by 2 minus x, this 5 minus 4x plus x square, it is 1 plus 4 minus 4x plus x square, 1 plus 2 minus x whole square, and 1 plus 2 minus x whole square, as it is linear one quadratic is there, linear quadratic, so linear to 1 by t put linear is equal to 1 by 2, so minus dx is equal to minus 1 by t square dt, minus minus cancel, dx is equal to 1 by t square dt, and in place of 2 minus x just put 1 by t, and in place of 1 plus 2 minus x whole square put 1 plus 1 by t square whole root over, it becomes 1 by t square dt, it becomes 1 by t plus t square plus 1 root over by t, t t t square, they cancel, it becomes dt by t square plus 1, it is ln t plus, the formula is dx by x square plus a square, you just go to chapter 4, you will find this formula, and it is ln t plus t square plus a square root over, put the value of t, and that is 1 by 2 minus x, as 2 minus x 1 by t, so what is t, it is 1 by 2 minus x, and put the formula here, and 1 plus 2 minus x whole square by 2 minus x square, it becomes 1 plus 5 minus 4x plus x square root over by 2 minus x, because it is 2 minus x. When you will take LCM, it will become also 2 minus x. 1 plus 2 minus x whole square, you know 1 plus 2 minus x whole square is 5 minus 4x plus x square. So its root over is this. Okay? Now look at number 24. 23 is very easy. You can put t square is equal to x plus 2. Then putting this value, you will get the answer. It is very easy. I am not doing that. Okay, this is not in the form of 21, 22. It is linear root over. It is linear quadratic root over. In case of linear root over, no problem. Put just t square is equal to x plus 2. But look at number 24. This is a star mark problem for exam point of view. This is the only important problem. Very important problem. Very important problem. Look at this problem. 1 plus x square by x into x power plus 1 root over. Divide x square in numerator and denominator. It is when you divide x square here and here, it becomes 1 plus 1 by x square. When you divide x square, x into root over of x power plus 1 by x square. Look at here. When you divide x square, it becomes 1 plus 1 by x square. When you divide x square, write simply. It is 1 plus 1 by x square. By x power plus 1, by what? X, take x square, take the whole root over dx. It becomes what? 1 plus 1 by x square. When you divide this, it becomes x square plus 1 by x square, whole root over dx. It is 1 plus 1 by x square. Take this as x minus 1 by x whole square plus 2. Because if x minus 1 by x whole square, it is x square plus 1 by x square minus 2 plus 2. They cancel. So it becomes what? 1 plus 1 by x square and x minus 1 by whole square plus 2. Put z is equal to x minus 1 by x. Dz is 1 plus 1 by x square dx. So in place of this, put just dz. It is z square plus 2 root over. It is ln z plus z square plus 2 root over. Formula of dx by x square plus x square root over. In place of z, put x minus 1 by x. It is x minus 1 by x whole square plus 2. It is x minus 1 by x whole square plus it becomes x square plus 1 by x square. It is take LCM x here. It becomes x square minus 1. And when you take LCM x square here, it becomes x fourth plus 1 root over. And the denominator is x square root over, that is x. Here x, taking 1. Common LCM. The answer is ln x square minus 1 plus x fourth plus 1 root over divided by x. Now look at number 25. X minus 1 by 2x plus 1 whole root over. It is x minus 1 root over by 2x plus 1 root over. Linear by linear dx. Always try to put t square in the denominator so that it will be a single term. So put t square is equal to 2x plus 1. Then 2t dt is equal to 2dx. Then dx is t dt. So x is what? X is here x is t square minus 1 by 2. X minus 1 is t square minus 1 by 2 minus 1. It is t square minus 1 minus 2 by 2. It is t square minus 3 by 2. Look at here. This is very important for me. X minus 1 is what? T square minus 3 by 2. Now look at here. So what is x minus 1 root over? It is t square minus 3 whole root over by root 2. So in place of x minus 1 root over, I am writing what? X minus 1 root over, I am writing t square minus 3 root over by root 2. In place of 2x plus 1, I am writing t. And in place of dx, I am writing t dt. So t, when after simplification, it becomes this. Into t dt, t t cancel, 1 by root 2 go to outside, t square minus 3 root over by into dt, s, x square minus s square root over formula is, I am applying x by 2, x square minus s square root over, minus s square by 2, ln x plus t square minus 3 root over. The interesting is, in place of t, you put the value, in place of t, 2x plus 1 root over by 2. But in place of t square minus 3, I am putting box here. Look at here. T square minus 3 is what? 2x minus 2. Just look at here. in place of 2, t square minus 3 root over, I am writing 2x minus 2. So it is 2x minus 2 root over, minus 3 by 2 ln, in place of t, I am applying 2x plus 1 root over, and in place of t square minus 3, I am writing 2x minus 2 whole root over. Okay, plus. Here number 26, it is x by a square minus x square in root over into also root over of x square minus b square. In this place you can put t square to this part, also you can put t square to this part. But I am taking t square is equal to x square minus b square, because I take the positive, x square minus b square, that is put t square is equal to x square minus b square. If you will put also this, you can also find the same answer. Now 2t dt is equal to 2x dx. Now 2 cancel. T dt is x dx. Now what is x square? X square is t square plus b square. Okay. I am interested to find a square minus x square. A square minus x square matlab kya hai? A square minus t square minus b square. A square minus b square. A square minus t square minus t square. I am taking a square minus b square is a constant, I am taking it again at k square. So k square minus t square. A square minus x square root over means k square minus t square ka root over. So it becomes what? It becomes x dx. In place of x dx, we have to write t dt. And in place of a square minus x square root over, and here you have to put k square minus t square root over. In place of x square minus b square root over, you have to put t. So cancel. It becomes dt by k square minus t square root over. It is sine inverse t by k. Sine inverse t matlab kya hai? T is x square minus b square root over by k. K matlab kya hai? S square minus b square root over. It is sine inverse x square minus b square by s square minus b square whole root over plus c. And I am doing number 25, 26, and you will do by yourself 23. It is my repeated request to you, you should do the problems first, then after you should verify with my answer. Okay.